you're done. You don't actually own your freaking device. Today, I'm going to show you how we're going to keep Android an open ecosystem. So I've been talking about this recently and this whole end of Android freedom, Google's plan to essentially kill off all third-party installations on Android so that you can only install apps through the Play Store. It's literally iOS, but now on Android. F-Droid is probably the most popular open source app store on Android, and they have straight up said that this will kill them. Essentially, all developers out there, even if they don't even want to upload their apps to the Play Store, now have to pay a fee to Google, agree to Google's terms and conditions, provide government identification to Google, upload evidence of their private signing key, and list all current and future application identifiers. This means even if you're a competitor to Google, you now have to give your personal information to develop an app, even if you don't want to publish to the Google Play Store. So I love the way the site breaks it down, and I'll cover this a lot more. It's that you, the consumer, purchase a device believing in an open ecosystem. And yeah, Google is killing that off. You as a creator, aka developer, can no longer develop an app and share it directly with friends, family, and your community without seeking Google's approval first. This was previously kind of the biggest separation between Android and iOS, and Google is trying to change this in the next year. And of course, this is something people haven't been talking about, and I'm glad they put it in here. The state. As a country, if you are the US, if you are France, if you are India, doesn't matter who you are removing the rights of your citizens and your own digital sovereignty to a company with a track record of complying with demands of authoritarian regimes to remove perfectly legal apps. What do they mean by this? They mean how in places like Russia, they have straight up removed the voting app, because it was pretty much demanded by the authoritarian government there. We see similar things happen with VPNs in places like China and Russia. VPNs are constantly delisted in those regions and on the App Store. And then when you don't have a way to alternatively install applications via sideloading, you're done. You don't actually own your freaking device. It's quite simple. If you're a country and you care about democracy, you should be against this because it allows people to actually install software in their devices, regardless of what any country's trying to impose on their citizens. The stakes are high, not just for F-Droid, but for all of us. Me, you, and developers, and really the entire mobile ecosystem. Even if you're on an iPhone, the fact that this won't exist will only reinforce the idea that what Apple is doing is not only okay, but actually the only choice, and they can probably take things a step further. So this is bad for everybody, even if you're only on an iPhone. But let's go into what we actually do about this, which is really the new update to this video. So there's this wonderful website that since I published my last video is now live. It's called keepandroidopen.org. And I'll of course leave this linked down in the description. And the goal here is to really just give you a TLDR on everything that you/we/all of us can do to fight this. It's really quite simple. If you're a consumer, it's really important. And they do outline this. And I see this a lot in the comments. Oh, they're not going to do anything. Guys, no, if a lot of you say something, they will listen. Regulators, especially the ones who care about regulating, will care about this. Europe just passed the DMA. They spent years passing the DMA, and this in many ways seems to violate the DMA. So a lot of regulators might not know this yet. And so if all of you are reaching out to them, it's very important. This is especially impactful when it's authored by a citizen of that country or region, and when the language of the email is written in one of the official languages of the governing body. Request a written acknowledgement of the complaint and consider forwarding any response you receive to victory@keepandroidopen.org so that we can highlight and reference them. So that's something that literally anyone watching this video can do. You're going to find local regulators in wherever you live, write in your official language, send it off, ask for an acknowledgement, and then send it back to victory@keepandroidopen.org. This might take you a total of about 5 to 10 minutes, and that's a one-time thing you need to do. Ideally, you do it more often, but if all of you just did this once, that's huge. If you want direct URLs, they even link things in the European Union, they link things in the UK, in the US, some of those impacted by the government shutdown. Awesome. Brazil, Singapore, Thailand, Indonesia, Australia, Japan, South Korea, India, Canada, Taiwan, Turkey, Argentina, Mexico, and the Philippines. And if there's nothing on here for a region that you're more familiar with, I'm sure you can contact the organizers here of the website and let them know some extra links that they can add to it. Now, besides contacting regulators, of course, you install F-Droid. That's a big thing that you can do so that you are now a user of the alternative platforms and that you can better keep up with what's going on. Also, if you're an organization, you can add your signature to this open letter that they're going to be sending to Google. And this is on CryptPad. It's going to take a while to load because it is on CryptPad. Hey, there we go. So you can read this letter in full. I've already expressed my interest in signing this via TechLore to some of the F-Droid people, and so I believe we'll be included in that. If you have any organization, please reach out to this email and include your name, title, affiliation, and that you intend to sign this, and that's another thing that you can do. All of you can provide feedback directly to Google using their Android Developer Verification Requirements Survey. You can make your voice heard on social media with blog posts and link to this. You can combat astroturfing. So if there are suspect posts on community forums and social media, feel free to actually correct them. And then also help out the project by editing the webpage with more useful information. Again, if you're more familiar with a specific region and it's not linked here, you can go ahead and edit it and include something else. And finally, there is a change.org petition that you can sign as well. And there are already over 13,000 signatures at the time of recording. Hopefully by the time you click the link down in the description, it'll be a bit higher. Actually, I have not signed the change.org petition yet. So there we go, sign. Besides those things, they leave other projects that you can contact, and you can also support other projects that are building some alternatives that are useful to mention. And of course, if you are a developer, do not sign up for the early access program, do not perform identity verification, or accept an invitation to the Android Developer Console. Respond politely to any invitation with a list of your concerns and objections. We also need to discourage other people who are developers from signing up for this. You can also include the free Droid Warn library in your code to inform your app users. And yes, this is a whole new open source thing that was put out, which is a warning that you can implement into your app to help out with this. So there are so many things that we can all be doing, and some of us are developers, some of us are users, some of us are just on iOS, some of us are on wherever. No matter where you are, there's at least one thing you can do, and in most situations, more than one thing. And most of these are just one-time things that take almost no time to do. We're not that big, and it's still performable for us, and these people are bigger than us and are getting more views on this. And so my point is, this is a universally disliked thing, and it doesn't take that many of you to make a huge impact. Do not think that you won't make a difference. You literally can make a huge difference. You know, this is a global fight. Google's trying to push this out globally. And so if we're working with maybe 5 to 10 million people who are well aware of this, and if they're all, you know, reaching out to all of their regulators in their specific region, it will filter out to each specific country. And by the time it's down to each specific region, it's going to be quite a bit slimmer. So you really do matter, because there might not be a huge number of people where you live who are following this that closely. So please, please, please get involved, and do not think that you aren't helpful. If you own a Windows computer, you don't need to register with Microsoft to run any software on your computer. You can just download anything from your browser. And it's the same thing with Mac, and it's the same thing with Linux. But right now on your phone, the situation is, if you have an iPhone, the only way to install apps is to create an Apple account and download apps from the App Store. There is no other way to do this. Google has apparently just been so gracious this whole time to offer us an alternative on the Android side of things, because on Android, you can just install an APK from a website, you can install F-Droid, you can install the dozens of alternative app stores out there that exist. But now Google is closing this gap and looking almost totally the same as iOS. And once both major platforms require this, there is nowhere left to go. The entire mobile ecosystem becomes a walled garden. And as we've seen, there is more and more web traffic moving to the mobile ecosystem in the last few years. And so this is going to be a permanent thing unless we act now. This goes beyond F-Droid. This is about whether smartphones can ever really be truly open devices again that you actually own. The concept of you giving money for a device that you can install whatever software you want on it, regardless of where you live, who you are, or what you want to install. That might go away. And that is why you should go in the description and get active. That's all I have to say. Check out that link down in the description. If you want to watch a little bit more context about what's going on and what this looks like, you can watch my previous video here. And I will be sure to update you all on anything that happens. In fact, I've already done an interview with Mark from F-Droid, and we talk a lot about this. And so that interview will be coming out in the coming weeks. So stay subscribed, and I'll see you next time on TechLore.